Hey guys, Don Diader here. I got a lot of questions in my live stream about my Fallout mods. So, yeah, today I'm just going to show you a few of the mods I use and, of course, the website I use. As you can already see, I use the Nexus Mod Manager. I got, like, the Walking Dead mod. That's why the ghouls are always, walking instead of running. And, of course, there's a custom sound to it and everything. And, of course, I use the New Vegas anti-crash, because without it my game keeps crashing, so that's something I use. Buildings, I just use a shitload of those. I always switch a bit up with these kind of mods, with like houses and shops and all that. Clothing, also something you can switch up. Although I must say I really love these glacier glasses. I keep using them in a lot of different playthroughs, so that's of course a pretty good recommendation, I think, if you're into the those kind of things. All kind of backpacks. Just some companions. I think this one I just recently installed, so there's a chance if you see. I think I already know which one it is. Yeah, lately I just use a lot of these companions, but I think I already used it in a live stream. It's a pretty cool one. Of course, Cam is a really good mod. It's the mod I use for all my cocaine, heroin, Breaking Bad kind of style mods, you could say. There's like a lot of Easter eggs in it, drug labs, and it keeps expanding. Of course, there's the real alcohol in it, the Corona, Heineken, Budweiser, tequilas, what have you, rum, whiskey. It's just a really good mod. Of course, I also got like more perks, Nevada skies. It's the weather mod I use for the snow and the nuclear clouds and all the kind of good stuff. You can see my streams. Of course, I also got the perk every level. I just love perks, so why not? Although it makes the game sometimes a little bit easy. Of course, I think you guys can read it here. It's just you can enable power armor a little bit faster. Got Project Nevada, of course. Enclave patrols at the moment. Just recently new to my mods, but yeah, I think it's pretty cool. I really love the Enclave, so not sure what this is again, but oh wait, that's for character creation. That's of course the robotic face I can use and that kind of stuff. So also pretty good mod. Barber mirror. It's in your house, so you can change haircuts and stuff. Pretty basic, but must have. And just underneath it is Role Players Alternative Start. It's also a must have for me. Same for Skyrim. I think I can make a video with mods for that later on. I still didn't fix my live stream for it. It's a pretty hard game, so yeah, I can't reassure I can live stream it, but yeah, those alternative start mods, they're really important for your game, I think. I always use them, it's just something that's always in my playlist. Caliber X, of course, the realistic ammo kind of stuff. Pretty good, also a must-have. Custom Pip-Boy I use in my live streams, pretty good one. I really prefer this one. You have like a lot of Pip-Boys, but just personal preference. This is a combination, the Shadows gas mask breathing mod, with like a few different mods for the gas breathing sound I have, and I think it's Project Nevada, a combination with that. It's pretty good. Can also really advise that for a bit more realistic gameplay. Weapon mod menu, just the basic thing you gotta have. Animation replacer, also must have. A shitload of millennia weapons, going into that later on. And of course the configuration menu, but I think we'll go to the internet now and show you a bit around. Of course I use the Nexus mods, always use it for games from Bethesda. Same for Skyrim, I believe Steam also have like mods on it, but yeah, you can't really compete with Nexus. It's just much better, it's much more professional. Just take a fast look for the recent mods that are out. Not something I'm going to add. Sometimes you can really see cool ones. I'm thinking about Sammy the Ghoul. Maybe I will add that later on, but gotta think about it. Christmas special. Nah. Let's see what's most endorsed. As you can see, Nevada skies, mod configuration. Just a lot of A lot of mods I'm using are on the first page already. Of course, NVAC. Really must have unlimited companions, maybe if something like that. Not sure which one I use. There are a lot of those mods. Wasteland Oval is also one I really use a lot. Not for the live stream I'm doing at the moment, but yeah, it's one I use a lot. Of course, Weapons of Millennia. Let's go to Millennia. I really want to show you this. I think yesterday he added a new weapon. I still need to test it, but maybe tomorrow I do a live stream. So let's go to that weapon. Suomi, I think it's maybe Swedish or something, I really got no clue, but yeah, I can just show you a bit what this guy can do, if it's loading. The only thing I have sometimes with this is that the website is just slow, so I don't think it want to load up. That's too bad. But yeah, you also have like snow design and different versions of this weapon. Ah, here you can see it. You also have like round drums for it and whatnot. Make me think a bit of the Russian PPSA, but that's a different gun. He also has that one. Let me see, maybe I can load this one up. This is the snow version. I'm really planning on use that since, as a lot of you guys know, I'm going a little bit into the snowy Fallout style at the moment. So, of course, most are in Doc Mitchell's house. Pretty good. Here it is. It's pretty cool. I think it's pretty cool. A little bit different, but if you want guns in your game, go to Millennia and add every gun from him. It's just a really great weapon designer. Always weapons are just must-haves. Dragunovs, PKMs, Steyr Scouts. Let me see which one is cool. I really love the PKM. Yeah, I'm just going to show you guys the PKM too. It's pretty high detail. Of course, you guys already know it since, I used it on my live streams and stuff. So, really advise Millennia. Really check him out. He's really has like a lot of good mods. I can't really make like videos of Fallout itself. I think live streams are much easier to make than videos with recording. It's just less hard for your PC. So. I think we'll keep it at live streams, but maybe I will make mod reviews later on. But of course, we gotta see that. A lot of cool mods. Let me see. Companions. Let's go to companions. Maybe I can advise a few good companions if you guys are into building your own little army. Of course, better Veronica, better Cass, just basic, but I can really help your game out. Sunny Smells companion, very good one, but they're all a little bit basic. I think Russell was a fun one, but you need a quest mod for that, so yeah, if you want quests and companions in a combination, can advise this one, but yeah, you gotta see it for yourself. Desmond Harper, still want to test that one out, didn't do it yet. I think on the second page. I never used too much from the first page, but let me see. Also love basic ones, of course. Cyan for my live streams. Really love that this one. It really fits my drug dealer playstyle I do sometimes. So really good one. Milton and Hans. Didn't use that in a live stream yet, but they're pretty cool. Pretty cool. I think most people watch him, and that's El Chess Breach. He also has like videos with them, I believe. They're pretty cool. Really advise that one. Searching for one, but maybe I need to type his name. Also thinking about adding the Pack Brahmin. Little bit of realism, you could say. At the moment I got Hope Lies. Yeah, that's the one I use at the moment. It's a really great one. I really love it. It's a bit like a girl from Texas or something with accent and stuff. And yeah, it's just something I really recommend. It's just a really great mod. Yeah, you got Yorgi for the people that really love power armor. Of course, Steve the Red Roach. Everyone knows that from El Chess Breach. Here you have El Chess Breach himself. So, yeah, just so much companions. But the one I think is underrated. It's not professionally made, but that's Pedro the Mexican Ghoul. I'm not using it at the moment. It is a bit glitchy, but he talks a lot about tacos and stuff, a bit stereotyped, but I think he's really cool. He's a bit like, if you love Raul, you're going to love this one. You can give him custom clothes, weapons. He just has like a big starter pack of gear. Just his suit, and he uses Maria, the pistol, also. Yeah, it's just a really great companion. Yeah, I just advised, if you like simple companions, although it is a bit glitchy, not sure if there is... Let's see the comments. Yeah, they're just talking about voice acting and stuff, so... Maybe it will be done a little bit more professionally later on. But, yeah, as you can see, it's a pretty cool companion. And I love myself some Mexican ghoul styles. I think there are not enough Mexicans in Fallout New Vegas. I think they're pretty cool for their companions and stuff with the accent. Just like, I think Danny Trejo did the voice of Raul. I think it's pretty cool. Yeah, I really love Raul. And especially if you compare him with Boone and stuff. I'm not a big fan of Boone. A lot of people like Veronica. I love the character, but yeah, I'm not really into the... Yeah, the power fist kind of weapon, so... That's not really my thing, as you can see, a lot of armors and stuff. I think I need to add a ghillie suit later on, maybe in a different playthrough, but... I think this one is new, not sure though. Maybe it's updated. Looks pretty cool. Yeah, maybe add it later on, but of course I'm playing with snow and not much trees at the moment and stuff, so... yeah, just a lot of great armors, of course. Gas mask of the world, must have. Gotta show you guys this one, of course. This is just the most important armor mod for me, and it's recently updated. You got transparent, yeah, how do you call those? Those eye pieces, you could say. Of course, this is compatible with Project Nevada or something, so that's... what I use in my live stream here, as you can see. Really great one, but it can really hammer down your performance, so yeah, advise that for better PCs. Yeah, let's go to quest. I'm just going to show you a few of the quests I did, and I think I keep it at that then, but yeah, just wanted to show you guys a bit what I use, what I like. You can hear me talk a lot more about mods and stuff in my live streams and gameplay, and of course, the big overhaul mod is upcoming, Lone Star in Texas. Can't wait for it, it's going to be great, so... yeah, in my live stream you just see a lot more about it, but... Let's go to Most Endorsed. For the Enclave, never did that one, although I want to play it. Think I played this one, not sure. Searching for a certain one. Not sure where it is. I thought it will be on the first page. Maybe it's deleted. Ah, Neptune Rebuilt. Also a great one. You really need to get money and certain supplies and build up your town. It might be a bit unrealistic when it's finished, but... Yeah, just a great one. Can really advise that one if you like building up. Same with Wasteland Defense and Real-Time Settler. Great mods for building up stuff. Don't see it at the moment, but they are really great mods. And I'm looking a bit around. I can't really find it at the moment. It's pretty weird. Maybe I'm just looking over it. Maybe it's renamed, maybe it's deleted. But it was like a big city and it was almost like Fallout 3. And it was really, really cool. It was really a cool mission. Let me see. Maybe it was on the first page. Can't stand it. I can't see it at the moment. Maybe it was Doxy Denver. Doxy Denver. Let me see. Not sure though. I think I also played this one, but it was a different one I was talking about. But nah, maybe I can find it later on, and then I will say it or something. But yeah, that was really a great mod with a lot of combat and super mutants and stuff. But there's so many great mods out there. I really advise looking for yourself. If you want some tips looking for certain mods, you can always ask, but the best thing is just go into it and search for yourself. So I hope that was a bit useful for you guys. If you want yeah, more information about how to install the Nexus Mod Manager, make account stuff, you can always ask me or, well, anyone on the website. I think they also got like a chat box on it. You can always ask people there for new mods and stuff, but... Yeah, just a great website, and thanks again. Hope to see you guys next time.